The five stupid reds. This is a routine I know from an old coach and a very good snooker referee from Belgium, Daniel Bontik. It's called stupid reds because really it looks boring, but the routine is very important. I'm IBSA head coach Brando. Stay with us to see very nice beginner's routine. The five stupid reds. Boring routine, but very useful. I'll show you the idea of the routine, which is not only to pot the ball, but to memorize the angles, to use different spins, and how to play the routine. You have five positions here on the table, so you need to pot the blue from those five positions. First you start with the straight shot, and then you move to one of the angle shots. If you miss, then don't repeat the shot, go on the other side. The idea of this is not to get stuck on a single shot. Even century break players can do this routine. But for them, the goal is going to be not to miss even a single shot and to pot all the balls in the middle of the pocket. Play this with the different spins. Top spin, the stern shot, the screw back shot. And what to do if you are missing a single shot to one part of the pocket? This is a problem with your aiming or with your cueing. So let's say I'm missing the straight shot a little bit to the left. I'm gonna miss the shot a little bit to the left. I'll hit the left jaw. Then you probably are going to miss again on the same place. Now I'm missing again on the same place. I think I'm aiming into the pocket, but I'm actually not. Now I miss on the same place. What you have to do now is to try to hit the right jaw of the pocket. Now I'll go down on the shot. Now I think that I'm aiming on the right jaw of the pocket. Actually, this is straight. Now I strike the ball, and that's perfectly straight. This is what you have to do on particular shots. It could be a straight shot, could be one of the angle shots. So if you're continuing missing on one side of the pocket, just don't aim for the pocket next time. Aim for the other jaw and then just observe where the ball is going. Observing the balls will help you to memorize the potting angles. You can play this with topspin, just a simple topspin with one cushion. I observe that I pot the ball a little bit on the left side of the pocket, and I'm century break player, so that means that I probably need to practice this little bit more. Now I go from the other side. I'll play it with the stern shot, just a simple stern shot. Now I noticed that I've potted the ball little bit on the right side of the pocket. That gives me information, and this is very valuable information. So practice this, observe where the balls are going, in the middle of the pocket or left or right, stay down on the shot, and if you miss, then try to adjust your aiming next time. Don't be thinking it's your cue action. It could be the cue action, but in most of the cases, it is your aiming. You may think you're aiming for the middle of the pocket, but if the ball is not going there, then obviously you're wrong. You have to aim next time, not for the middle of the pocket, but slightly right or slightly left. And this is for a shot which you cannot pot consistently. And this is how you will remember the potting angles. Very good, very important routine. I know it's boring, but you may start your warm up with this little routine. You can use it on the blue spot, on the pink spot, on the black spot, or wherever you feel you need to. Thank you for watching. See you in our next videos.